The hologram effect will bring your video into the future. In this video, we're gonna go step by step through the process of making the hologram effect in DaVinci Resolve. Now I'm gonna go as fast as possible while explaining, but if you have to pause the video, just go ahead. Let's just get right into it. If you're new here, hit the subscribe button and the bell notification to be updated on the newest DaVinci Resolve tutorials put out. So before we get into DaVinci, you need a few things. You need a video of yourself or someone else pretending like there's a hologram there that they're interacting with. Once you've shot the video, you're gonna need a screen recording of YouTube or something like that that you wanna be scrolling through. Also, be aware how many times you scroll in your video, so you can also scroll that many times in your screen recording. And then finally, you're just gonna need some kind of video that pops up. It could be any video on YouTube. You could just use 4K video downloader and just download it right there. Once you have all that, you're ready to go. So let's jump into DaVinci Resolve. So now that we're in DaVinci Resolve, what we're gonna do is we're gonna add in and out points to every one of our clips and drag them into our timeline. So I have all of my in and out points already set. So all I'm gonna do is I'm gonna just drag this in, go to my next clip. So for this one, I'm gonna grab the video only because you don't really need the audio. This is the video that pops up when I click on it in the hologram. So you only need the first like 5 seconds of it and then just drag it on there. You want the audio and video for that one. Now we have our clips on our timeline and we can now start building the sequence. So once I click this, I want the hologram to pop up. So I wanna grab my hologram layer, which is just a screen capture, and I wanna just drag it right into that place. Now you can see that it's just black bars right now. So go to cropping and just crop this to where you like it. I personally cropped the top bars out because I don't want it there, it just looks ugly. And I also cropped the navigation buttons and the notification and stuff like that. So I'm just getting the menu itself. So now you can see when I hit the button on my phone, it pops up. The next thing we wanna do is we wanna position everything. Now this is gonna take some time, so at times I'll speed it up. So I'm gonna click on my hologram layer and I'm gonna hit flip. And then I'm gonna drop the opacity just so I can see through it. We'll have to do it again in Fusion, but then I'm gonna move it where I think it would look good. Make it smaller if you need to. Then we're gonna start messing with the pan, and then you're gonna wanna start making this go sideways. So now it's starting to look like it's actually facing me. So now that I got this first hologram pop up where I want it, I'm just gonna do the same thing for this next one. And when you see me click right here, it's gonna pop up. I'm gonna mute this track because this really doesn't need to be on. So now that we have it in place, you see that it just takes over the frame. So zoom out on it, position it the way it should be, flip it, drop the opacity, do the same exact thing you did for this one right here. So now everything is positioned the way we want it. The next step is to time remap it, because right now you can see this is scrolling without me even scrolling. I don't want that, that looks crappy. So we need to time remap it. So with this clip, I'm already starting in the zoom. So I might actually wanna move it here and grab this and just drag it out a little more to see if it's, yeah, see right there, it's not moving at all. So I'm gonna click on it right where it's frozen. I'm gonna right click and I'm gonna go to retime controls, or you can hit control R if you're using my keybinds. If you want those, I have a video on that. Click the card in the top right, but come back to this video. So I want this part to be a freeze frame so this isn't moving. I'm gonna make sure my playhead is right where I want it to be frozen. And I'm gonna go to this drop down section, hit freeze frame, and now I can just adjust this, move this all around. So now that we have this freeze frame right here where it's not moving, I want it to start moving. You see my hand moving up? Well, I'm gonna grab this speed point and I'm just gonna drag it. So now it's gonna start moving with my hand. So looks like we got the first two scrolls pretty well and the third one is bad. So to fix this third scroll right here, you saw me wipe up and it didn't actually do anything. We're gonna retime that. I see that right here is where I start to swipe. Once again, I'll put my playhead right where I want this to start to scroll. I'll add a speed point on this and I'll go to where it starts to scroll fast. It's gonna be right here. Then I'm gonna add another speed point, wrap it, and you're just gonna drag it close to the other one. So now it looks like the hologram is moving with my fingers. Final thing to do is to add another freeze frame right here because it's gonna start going into the video and I just want it to stay on this menu right here. So I'm gonna make the freeze frame, drop down, hit freeze frame, and then it should be right there. Now I want this to stay, so I'm just gonna grab the freeze frame and drag it out as long as this bottom clip is. So we're about to jump into Fusion. Let's just trim the rest of this stuff off. We don't actually need any of this. Click on this and hit ripple edit, or you can cut it and delete it. So we have everything exactly where we want to. So we're gonna bring all of this into Fusion. Highlight everything, right click, go to new Fusion clip, and there it is. Now just jump right into Fusion. So now we have all of our inputs, and they're being connected by merge nodes and into our media out. So anytime in Fusion, this is the first thing that I do. I right click, go to options, go to orthogonal pipes, and now it makes everything right angles. And then right click again, go to arrange tools and do it to grid. So now it's gonna snap to the grid and everything will be right angles. It just looks nicer. So you can see that our full composition is in Fusion, and you also see that the opacity is back to normal. So the first thing we gotta do is we just have to drop it again. We're gonna go to our merge one, and we're gonna go to our alpha gain, and we're gonna drop that a little. And if that's not enough, you don't wanna go too far because it turns white. But if that's not enough, go to blend, and blend will start to actually drop the opacity even more. And then do the same thing for our other. So we're gonna name all of our clips so we know what we're working with. So now we're ready to make this effect come to life. We're gonna grab our merge nodes, our media out, and we're just gonna drag it over there, hit the screen node, and then control space, which will bring up the select tool, type in scan lines, and just hit add. Scan lines put lines running horizontally through your clip, so it's gonna simulate that like projection computer look. We want them a little smaller, so go to our line frequency and just bring it up to about 360, something like that. And then we're gonna wanna zoom in by hitting control and then just scroll using your scroll wheel, and make sure the lines are running horizontally with the bottom of your clip. So you're gonna mess with the line angle a little. So that looks good. Last thing we're gonna do is we're gonna click color and then go to this kind of teal, this is like really light blue color that just brings in more of like that hologram effect. So now we have to do the same thing for the video pop-up. So instead of doing that all again, we're gonna copy and paste the scan lines down here. So click on your node, hit control C, and then control V. So now we have our scan lines node right here, but we have to add it in. Grab it, hold shift, and then go down here. And when you see the line turn blue, let go. And now it adds it right in. So then when our clip finally pops up, you see it over here. The next thing we have to do is have that outer glow, because what hologram doesn't have a glow? So control space again, go to shadow and add this one and drag that in. So we want to go to the softness, and now you see that it actually brings about a shadow that surrounds the whole thing. Turn this black shadow into blue shadow. So just find it right here. That should be pretty good. So now we have that blue surround. We need to just make it a little less. It's a little too much right now. So we're gonna drop the softness down and also go to the alpha and just drop this down a little. Once again, we're gonna copy and paste this shadow onto the video layer. So on the shadow, hit control C and then control V, and it pastes this shadow node. Hold shift, drag it and drop it. So now we have the same effect over here. Now we have the glow around everything. This is what it looks like. So it looks good, but it's not complete. The swipe effect doesn't work. The pop-up animation from the phone to the hologram also isn't there. So we're gonna do that right now. So we're gonna add the animations by using transform nodes. So go to shadow and hit transform. So now under transform one, I'm gonna go to the beginning and I'm gonna find where I hit the button. So this goes right there. So I want it to actually end here. What we're gonna do is we're gonna start from the end and go to the beginning, because I already have everything positioned the way I want it. Under transform one, I'm gonna go to center and size. And then I'm gonna move back to where I hit the button, and I'm gonna start scaling it down to size and moving it over the phone. So that looks good. We can make it look smoother by going to our spline. Under transform one, you wanna highlight it and hit F, and then just go back and it looks a little smoother. So close spline out and go to your transform two, and then we know that the swipe animation is gonna happen over here. So I'm officially touching right now the hologram under my transform 2, hit size, center, and this is where I want it to start. And now I'm gonna go to where I want it to end. Now you see the flick of the wrist? Well, that's where I want it to be gone. So I'm gonna drop the size, make my ending point, and then under center, move my X and my Y. So now I'm gonna move it off a little more and drop the size. Got it right where we want it. It looks like my hand is swiping everything away, so we can make it look even better. So we can go under our merge, add some transparency to this. So once it's swiping away, it's actually getting more and more transparent. So for this, you're gonna click on your transform 2, and under your first keyframe, see right here, your first keyframe, you're gonna make sure it's on it, and then go to your merge 1, and under blend, you're gonna add a keyframe. Let's find where it goes away. So right here, should be gone. Let's add a second keyframe and drag this all the way down to 0. So now it looks like you're swiping it away. Go back to transform 2, and under setting, we're gonna go to motion blur. We're gonna have some quality motion blur right here. So add it about 5, but also drop the angle because you don't want it to be super blurry. You just want it to look like it's moving away. Let's watch this all the way through.
This week, I'm sharing the 5 things that you can do if you want to learn filmmaking outside of film school.
And that is how you do the hologram effect in DaVinci Resolve. I know this has been a longer video, but I hope you found it worth it. Would you be interested in more Fusion tutorials just like this? Let me know in the comments below. And also, if something comes to mind that you want to learn, also put that in the comments below. As usual, the video on the top is all about one of the best transitions packs that I have ever used in DaVinci Resolve. And the video on the bottom is a video that YouTube thinks that you would like. If you like this video, hit the like button, and if you like me, hit the subscribe button and the bell notification to be updated on the newest DaVinci Resolve tutorials put out. But until the next one, peace.